there's no speed control. It's either full speed or off side. I don't know if you know about three-parent babies that are being done.
Mm-hmm.
And all of the eugenics, modern-day eugenics, where we are fertilizing multiple eggs at once and then selecting one of them, the best one, and putting that into the womb of the mother and destroying the others. Is this the eugenics that Steiner was talking about when he said the Russian Slavic people will develop the occult eugenics in that sixth epoch? And then he says, in the year 8000, the moon returns. Think about what that means physically. If you're a scientist and the moon were to collide, today scientists say the entire dinosaur population went extinct 65 million years ago when a mere asteroid ran into the Earth near the Yucatan Peninsula. And it wiped out all life except for a few mammals or something, rodents or insects that survived. A vibrant Earth disappeared. Now think of a moon, much thousands of times bigger than any asteroid, colliding with the Earth. So physical life won't exist at this time. So I'm going to start asking, what is the human being? What is consciousness? And some people always say to me, why do we look back at the past? The answer is sort of this Giannis face. We have to know, what did the Egyptians think that thinking was in order to try to understand artificial intelligence today? And the Egyptian, the gods thought into them. They would never have said, I think, blah, blah, blah. They would say, you know, Osiris or Isis has inspired me, and this is what they said. In the Greek times, they would call on the muses, because they also weren't there yet, not until we got past the 9th century BC, would a Greek have said, I think. And so here's Isis speaking of her, you know, as this, with the wings, thinking into the pharaoh. So what about what Steiner calls thinking that is willed thinking? He says that's the only thinking that becomes free. And when does that arise? Well, it's been arising, but it's essential development of the period we're in now, the consciousness soul. And it's a big question to ask, are your kids able to will their thinking, or are we getting weaker through technology? Is the obstacle of technology for willed thinking too strong today? And if it is, how can we adjust that? As spiritual scientists, should we be trying to adjust that? So another parabola, and I think this is the last one of these, is tying back here where the world is full of spiritual beings. And then we started developing our ability to sense the physical world. So our senses became active, and in our soul, we could experience what those senses were showing us. But as we started doing that, our interaction through pictures of the spiritual world began to die away, so we developed the ancient mysteries. And then in the 9th century or 8th century BC, we started development of the intellectual soul. And in the midst of that, we had the Christ event, and those early Christians said, there is a coming time very soon at the end of the earth. And what they meant is that the earth and its ability to support the ancient mysteries, to support our ability through the earth to have spiritual experiences, was coming to an end, and it came to an end in the fourth century. And we see this symbolically represented with the Roman Emperor Justinian completes it, Diocletian, I think is his name, who incites these mobs to go and tear down the ancient mystery temples. And so all across the Roman Empire, the ancient mysteries disappear, and the hierophants, the great teachers there, flee, and they run to Baghdad and Gandhi Shapur, where Islam will soon come, and they help the flowering of Islam. So if you know about Charlemagne, when Charlemagne becomes the Franken king, his throne is in a wooden hut. And he's aware of these cities in Spain that the Moors have built, like Cordoba, where they have hospitals and schools and street lights and amazing culture that is centuries ahead. And so he travels to Baghdad and visits Harun al-Rashid. And Harun al-Rashid becomes so fond of this barbarian Charlemagne, who is seeking culture, that he gives them several teachers who come back and begin Chartres Cathedral and the great schools of Chartres and in France. And he also gives Charlemagne the keys to the holy sites, and the pilgrimages start. And when those pilgrims, several hundred years later, get slaughtered because Turks take over that area, and they don't know about this agreement, then the call for the Crusades begin. These cultural things are quite interconnected, and we don't know many of these connections. But we bring back from the Crusades all the secret knowledge, all the esoteric Christianity, and we have this flowering that occurs after the Templars are slaughtered. But we had with them the founding of the international banking system. Mm-hmm. So we reached this beginning of the Renaissance period and the development now of the consciousness soul. But back here, with the end of the earth, we also have the development of materialism that gets stronger and stronger and stronger, till finally we reach a point that says Jesus was just a good man. Within Christianity, I'm sorry, not within the world. In Christianity, we get to the point of just saying, maybe, but I don't believe any of that hocus pocus that the Bible tells me. Jesus was just a good man. To later, we get to the point of saying, who needs religion? And we get John Lennon's song. And today, we're at the point of, where do we find him? And if we seek him in the material world, he's not there. And we'll no longer find the Christ in the material world. As Steiner says, the true nature of the second coming is underway. He is to be found in the life sphere, the etheric, the chi, the prana world. Now, as we start devolution, or we finish this, and we're starting this path where our consciousness of the spiritual world should be beginning, we are meeting spiritual beings. They are here in this room. They are ever present with us and offering their help to us. at all times because they know the task we face is enormous. And they know we have not the wisdom to meet our own. And they're here to help us. So this age ends around 3573. Then we begin this Russian cultural age, which ends around 5733, if you're doing 2,160 years. And then comes this period where women are infertile. They become infertile from here to there. And why? Because the moon has already begun its descent ever since we brought back those moon rocks. Can't be measured yet, but it's already begun. And that will happen in the 8th or 9th millennium during the American cultural age. Will there be physical beings at that time? Will you have a body? So, what happens to our bodies? And I've circled some important points. Whoops. The end of the earth, women becoming infertile, and then these three are all connected back in the time when we experience a world full of spiritual beings to a time when we don't experience some, but they're around us just as much as them. He says, even Vulcan beings are here amongst us. But most importantly, the very beings that gave us anthroposophy, the beings that were present at the Christmas Foundation meeting, were the great teachers of humanity who left with the moon. And once these rocks came back, they came back. And they are present among us, preparing us for that moon return. So if the physical bodies are going to end according to me, where do I find that in Steiner? And in this book, this Fall of the Spirits of Darkness, especially Lecture 5, he talks about not only our own bodies, but the earth as withering and crumbling. And he says, you have to find that place, just like you do in old age, where you're not bemoaning this. You're not wishing it was otherwise. You've got to accept the old age of your body and the old age of the earth as it comes. And then, if some change didn't happen, he says, just as back in Atlantean times when human beings couldn't descend into physical bodies, it was too darn difficult. He goes, people are going to find no reason to incarnate into the same physical situation. So what does that mean? That's a fascinating problem to work out, that people would no longer find anything to do on earth. So something has to change in our inner life and the physical body. Human beings therefore have to find a different way of relating to earthly existence than what we have today. How will that be different? Well, we looked at one possible scenario, this integration of man and machine. We also talked last night about the beings who are going to be at the human stage on Jupiter also being amongst us with these other spiritual beings today and being a nuisance to us. And our need to develop this love for those beings as the beings who are our angels today, are our guardian angels. We were a nuisance to them and they love us so dearly. They will fall karmically with us if we fall. They will follow us to the greatest depths of the earth to help us back. That is love. And it's your choice what you do to your angel. That's responsibility. So I wonder, that's AL stands for me, the relationship between the inner life that we have and our physical body that must change. To me that means, and I'll show some other reasons why tomorrow, about a new rhythm connection between our spirit.